Today's tutorial will be on contemporary development economics. Under this paper, we'll talk about the environment and development. And in today's tutorial, we will restrict ourselves to the tragedy of commons. Now, you are familiar with this particular concept. So, in today's tutorial, we'll take an analytical treatment towards this. This will be part one. That means we will be dividing the tutorial on the entire lecture into two halves. Now, in the first part, what we are going to do is we will talk about a little bit of history. Now, this strategy of commons have been provided with a name. However, this particular issue has been discussed by many of the economists several times. Now, let us start. So, we'll start with Malthus. So, we are going to connect different links. So, this particular economist projected a linear growth path, and this is for food production. So, this is in case of food production. While he gave an according to him, there is an exponential growth path. And this is in case of population. And what does it result in? It actually results in an imbalance that propels natural and man-made disasters. So this is the first thing. So it is something, the gist or the analysis shows something which is similar to tragedy of commons. The next one was provided by David Ricardo, and he emphasized on the law of diminishing returns. As the word used by him was limit to growth, or you can even term it to be stationary equilibrium. Now, with the growth in population, food demand rises, and we know that the cultivation spread to inferior grades of land. And he pointed out that the cost of cultivation actually increases and food prices increases. Now, he said that the land becomes increasingly scarce and the higher corn price makes the living condition of the worker, that means the wage earning class, increasingly deplorable. However, when we talk about the owners of the superior grades of land, they are one that enjoy rising rent, according to Ricardo in his model, and this eventually actually leads to growing inequality, and the process of growth comes to a halt through the operation of diminishing marginal return. So, what Malthus has emphasized in his model is he wanted, or he has emphasized on absolute, or you can even term it as Malthusian scarcity. While David Ricardo, and I have said what is the model all about, he emphasizes on relative or even you can even call it to be Ricardian scarcity. Now in this discussion we must add the marginalist neoclassical school, and from this there are several economists. I'll talk about Pigou. So his contribution was that he considered nature as a form of capital which is drawn upon to generate the goods and services. Now he has mentioned that if the techniques of production or consumption, either of the other, generate pollution, the nature may cease to be sustainable. And therefore, what was his recommendation? He recommended the use of pollution tax as a cost of raising incentive to those who generate pollution. One more which I'll discuss, and then we will straight on move to the tragedy of commons. Now the hoteling analyze the optimal rate of exhausting the renewable resources. However, these sporadic references were watered down by neoclassical efficiency and growth paradigm. Now we are not going into that. Now the topic on which we will be discussing, actually this is all the missing links, or you can say all these talk about the same problem discussed in Tragedy of Commons. Now Hardin is a bioscientist who has referred to the Tragedy of Commons as a limit to growth, and this is done during the first half of the 20th century. Now we are not going to go into the explanation that has been provided by Hardin, and that he has contradicted the Bentham approach of the welfare state, which is also known as the welfare state definition. We are not going to go into that. Here we are there to, I have given you the links, and here we are to take an analytical approach towards this Tragedy of Commons. So let us begin. Now what we are going to do, we will explain the problem of Tragedy of Commons with reference to common access local resources. So I'll just give you a rough plot, and this we will be doing in our next tutorial. Now what we will do, we will be considering an example. Say a village pond is our example that we are going to consider, and which has a uniformly, or you can even call it to be equally distributed fish stock. Okay, fish stock, and we will consider some individual that belong to, we will divide them to the low income group, that means the traditional users. And we will make some assumptions, some simplified assumptions will be made. And then we will derive the optimization, we will do the optimization, arrive at the optimized value, as well as depict the entire thing graphically.